If this isn't working at home mom life, I don't know what is. So we're on a bouncy ball to keep her occupied, and I'm going to teach you how to add events to your Squarespace 7.1 site. If you are interested in learning about creating events in Squarespace 7.0, I will go ahead and link this video here, and I also show you how to set up payments. So now for Squarespace 7.1, go to Pages. If you do anything under Main Navigation, it's going to pop up here. So at first, that's not what I want. I want it under Not Linked. So you go to the plus, and then you go down to Events. There's just two styles Squarespace gives you. So we will just do, doesn't really matter, we'll do this one. And then it's just a matter of adding in your events. A few things that I wanted to note for you guys. I'm going to link the Inside the Square, Bekah is her name, a tutorial she gives, and she shows you that how to add with code a time zone, so like Pacific Standard Time. And that's really important, especially if you're doing virtual events, because people need to know the right time zone. And then she also shows you can have a little like icon up here. Let's see if we can find it in her tutorial, that you can change the color of. Let me grab that little image for you. So right here where it says July 10th, she'll give you code to change the color of that, add some lines around it, whatever. So I'm going to link this YouTube video as well in the description below. All right, so from there, you can go in, of course, change text the same way in the header that you would just going up to edit. But over here, you see these upcoming events, and you can just go in and edit them, or you can come up to the plus right here, and it'll create a new event. It starts off as a draft. So if you are not seeing it on your live site, that's because it still is a draft. So just make sure you publish it prior. They've kind of laid this out similar to blog posts. So if you've done any blog posts in Squarespace 7.1, this should come pretty easily for you. And then we're just following the steps. So event title, adding the date and time, adding the location if that's applicable, saving it. And it's like a blog post. You can go ahead and write about the event if you want to make, you know, some of it, heading, whatever. Once you're done, you're going to go up here and click publish or schedule, whichever one is what you're wanting to do. So let's go to publish, and it will pop up over here. If you're wanting to add a photo for the event, you can go to those three dots and click settings and just add an image right here. And like, just like a blog post, if you have it kind of on a main page, the excerpt is where you add some of the basic information, one sentence about the event. A few things to note: you can't have recurring or repeating events, but you can always duplicate an event. And you can't set up payments under events. If you want to do that, you're going to need to do that under scheduling. So to get to the scheduling, you go back, and over here is where you can see the scheduling. And this is how you would get people to pay for the events and things like that, if that's an option you want to offer. So to give you a very broad overview, this is where you would set up the scheduling. And once that's all set up, you go to one of your pages. Let's say you want it on your homepage, and you want like a block or a section where people can schedule one of your services or whatever. It's just a matter of adding a new section, just the same way that you would add a section. We'll scroll down, we'll add it right here. Edit, add section, and then you scroll down, you will see the ability to add scheduling here. Just make sure, of course, that you have set up that scheduling section prior. I'm gonna link a Squarespace article with a video tutorial that they've already created, so that I don't just repeat everything that they've already done. And hopefully that answers your questions. If you have any other Squarespace questions, leave them below and I will do my best to answer. Also, if you have a Squarespace website, an imperative part of making your website show up on Google is SEO. If you want to learn more about that, I have a three-day free challenge that you can go ahead and take, and it'll guide you through all the things I've done on my clients' Squarespace websites to improve their SEO and get them ranking on page one of Google. So I'll link that below as well.